this is GILA. Perhaps as horrific as the sight of peaceful protesters being attacked by police with batons and tear gas in Ottawa the other day, with one protester, actually a disabled woman of Mohawk heritage, ending up in hospital after being mown down by a police horse, have been the lies and slander about ordinary working class Canadians as supposed white supremacists by tyrant Trudeau and mainstream Canadian media. That seems to be the usual knee-jerk leftist reaction nowadays, if you're white. As American teenager Kyle Rittenhouse outrageously discovered when falsely accused of being a racist as well as a murderer. Fortunately, he's now in a position to sue the many people who have slandered him, and he's setting up a new foundation called the Media Accountability Project, which is sorely needed to bring all the mendacious political hacks that used to be journalists to account. Back to the truckers in Canada, who included Sikhs, Chinese, Black people, Native American Indians, among others among them, all they were actually seeking was freedom from COVID regulations. In particular, the requirement for all truckers to be vaccinated when some 90% of them already were. Just think how many people they could potentially have infected with COVID while sitting alone in their cabs for hours on end. Then there is the outrageous passing of the Emergencies Act in the Canadian Parliament. And anyone who's donated money to the truckers can have their bank accounts frozen, including, apparently, a single mother on minimum wage who donated a small amount to the Freedom Convoy, but now can't access what little money she actually has to feed her children or pay her rent. Did the same thing happen to supporters of the BLM who viciously rioted and caused real damage to people and property? Silly question. Even the Canadian Civil Liberties Association has declared that the legal standard has not been met for invoking what was actually meant as a measure only for extreme conditions in wartime. And at least one of the arrested trucker organisers, a mother called Tamara Leash, has been refused bail by an Ottawa judge called Julie Bourgeois, actually a political colleague of Trudeau. What a surprise! Because her detention is necessary for the safety and protection of the public. From what? Honking horns? Holding fun dance parties in sub-zero temperatures? Erecting bouncy castles for kids? Giving out food to the homeless? Clearing litter? No, it must have been the illegal parking, the one bit that you could argue was actually illegal, surely that constitutes the mischief she has been charged with and has made her too dangerous to be allowed out and to be home looking after her children before her trial. Today I listened to a video put out by True North, who are journalists actually seeking to report real news, showing a supposedly independent Canadian senator called Marilou McFeedron saying that elements inside the Freedom Convoy were, quote, publicly proclaiming that they want a racial war, and that if there isn't a racial war, then we will all soon be forced to speak Hebrew. The fact that this nonsensical, condemnatory drivel came out of the mouth of a supposedly non-affiliated Canadian senator, I find truly alarming. Oh, and by the way, as a native English speaker who's lived for the past 17 years in Israel, I can tell you that Hebrew is not an easy language to learn. I certainly still struggle with it and still frequently have to pass the phone to my husband, who speaks rather better Hebrew than I do, to deal with the person on the other end. And as a Jew myself, there is no way I would ever support anyone who genuinely was a white supremacist. Think about it. Or any other kind of supremacist either. Now, there are trucker convoys in the USA planning to arrive in Washington, D.C. in time for the senile, corrupt, imposter State of the Union address. And already it appears the National Guard is being called out there. Organisers are making clear that this is totally peaceful, non-political, and simply supporting freedom from all remaining COVID mandates, which are not actually working to stop the spread of the milder but highly contagious Omicron variant, however many vaccinations you may have had, as the Queen of England has now discovered. Personally, my left arm still aches, 6 weeks on from my last, actually, third vaccination, and I can't really lift heavy weights with it yet. But I'm lucky. Yesterday I met a lady who told me her child's school teacher is still confined to bed and can't move properly some 2 months after her last COVID vaccination. I can't help wondering what the likely overreaction of Biden's administration will be to the American truckers, and just how skewed most American mainstream reporting is likely to be about them. But in the meantime, tyrant Trudeau, who refused even to sit down and talk to these working class protesters, has succeeded not only in bringing many, many ordinary Canadians together against him and his diktats across Canada, but in setting off a populist and peaceful protest for freedom worldwide. And that, I believe, in the end, will be unstoppable. Thank you so much for listening.